Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Ivy English. Today is December 14th, and we're on page 43 in your magazines. Today, we're going to hear part two of the article that we started yesterday entitled A Trip to Brazil.
好，今天呢，我们要讲昨天那篇文章的第二部分。那我们的文章中文标题是文化大熔炉，热情国度巴西。
Okay, now I hope you're done salivating by now. Yesterday, we were talking about some of the wonderful food that you can find in Brazil. The first thing was feijoada, which is a stew containing black beans and various kinds of meat, such as beef jerky, smoked sausages, and salted pork, but sometimes other things as well, like pumpkin potatoes and bananas. So that already sounded really wonderful, but what really got our mouths watering, I think, was this caipirinha, which is the national drink of Brazil, made of sugar lime wedges, and cachaça, which is an alcohol that's made from sugarcane juice. Now, when I heard about this lime being smashed together with sugar, then mixed with ice, and then they add the alcohol, I can do without the alcohol. That really made my mouth water. So yesterday we found out about a lot of wonderful food and our mouths were watering. Today we're going to try and work off some of those calories.
好，所以昨天的文章里面呢，我们提到了这个巴西的国民美食啊，这个 feijoada 啊，还有呢这个一种巴西的调酒啊，那这个让我们觉得哇，这个看起来又吃啊，然后又这个调酒里面有柠檬，感觉酸酸甜甜的啊。那在昨天吃喝完之后呢，今天呢，我们要把昨天吃喝所累积的一些热量把它烧掉。
That's right. So let's find out about some of the things we can do to work off some of those extra calories. The art of rhythm and dance is also a key part of Brazilian culture. It is best seen in samba, an internationally popular form of music and dance. This unique musical tradition began with the African slaves who were brought to Brazil. With them came the traditional dances and hypnotic drum rhythms from their homelands. As the art form expanded, guitars, brass and wind instruments, and playful lyrics were added. Samba music and dance steps are always upbeat, and they encourage improvisation and self-expression more than most classical dance styles. The best place to experience the magic of samba music and dancing is at the famous carnival in Rio de Janeiro. Celebrated before Lent, it's the world's largest carnival, attracting around 2 million people annually. The first carnival was organized in 1723. At the time, there was a lot of tension between the Europeans and Africans living in Brazil. Instead of fighting, celebrating together was a way for them to put their differences aside for a short while so they could party, play music, and dance in the streets. Different social classes mixed together, allowing people to drop their identities and pretend to be someone else temporarily. Rich citizens often dress like beggars and roam the streets, while the poor put on expensive threads. People also cross-dressed, wore masks, and even went around with almost nothing on at all, which is a tradition that continues to this day. During Carnival, street parades are held throughout the cities of Brazil. Groups of people from the same neighborhoods and samba school students and teachers proudly show off their talents. The dancers dress in elaborate costumes and shake their bodies to the powerful percussive sounds coming from the live marching bands. Anything goes at Carnival, so everyone is free to join the fun and display their best dance moves. It's kind of scary when they say anything goes.
Yeah, 因为 anything goes, 大概可以翻成百无禁忌,
yeah,
什么都可以。
Yeah.
那这个其实在这样的这个情况之下，你说什么百无禁忌，这个听起来会让人有一点担心，因为说不定不小心就会产生犯罪事件。
Yeah, or you'll do some things you regret later.
Yeah, 或者你会做一些你后来会后悔的事情。
Yeah, so this kind of puts me on my guard.
Mm.
Back to the beginning, the art of rhythm and dance is also a key part of Brazilian culture.
好，所以呢 ，art 的艺术啊 ，rhythm 是节奏啊 ，dance 是舞蹈，所以节奏跟舞蹈这方面的这样的艺术呢，也是一个 key part， 就是一个关键的部分。Key 在这里是形容词啊，所以它表示关键的意思啊，它也是这个巴西文化很关键的一部分，就他们的舞蹈跟他们的这个音乐的节奏。
I think this is something that the African diaspora has contributed to many different cultures, including the U.S. culture.
好，这个 diaspora 通常是指这个犹太人的这个迁徙，但是呢，事实上它就是任何的迁徙都会用这个字。所以这个非洲人他们啊，这个当初不管是自愿还是非自愿的啊，被带到了美洲来，包括南美洲、北美洲。那这样的一个民族大迁徙呢，它对于南美的贡献其实大概也这里也可以看得很清楚。
Now this is not justifying slavery in any form, but this is really something major that Africans brought to many other countries is the musical tradition. So if you want to find the real heart and soul of something that's really American, go to jazz.
嗯，好，那我们并当然绝对不是说这个奴隶制度好，我们替大家讲话或怎么样的，好，任何形式的奴隶制度都是不对的，好，但是这个历史上面的这些这个不幸的事件，他们后来的造成的后果之一或者造成的影响之一，就是他们其实对于美洲啊，南美洲、北美洲的这个黑人音乐，对于南美洲、北美洲的音乐呢，其实有很深远的影响。那尤其像美国的话，你如果真的要了解美国的这个很重要的文化的一部分的话，其实你要去听美国的爵士音乐。
Right, because it involves improvisations. A lot of it comes, it has African origins. So that is something that's considered actually at the same level as European classical music in importance and in inherent value.
啊，这个爵士音乐呢，跟古这个欧洲的起源的古典音乐啊，在美国文化里面都是一样的重要啊，甚至有人会觉得爵士音乐可能更重要，因为爵士音乐代表了某一种的美国精神啊。
它
这个你啊，但是爵士音乐它的根啊是来自于黑人的音乐啊，它有这种其中牵涉到我们等一下会看到那个是啊 improvisation 啊，就是即兴表演，
嗯
啊，那这个还有它的这个节奏啊，它的这个音阶什么的都很特别。
That's right. And don't think that improvisation is doing whatever you feel like doing and that anybody can do it. There are a lot of rules to improvisation. We don't have time to talk about it today. But look it up online. You'll find a lot of interesting things. Another thing worth mentioning is that, and this is also in no way trying to justify the U.S., many, many more slaves were sent to Central and South America than were sent to North America. Now, America brought in many, many slaves, and eventually it became illegal and so forth and so on. Bringing in slaves became illegal long before slavery ended. You know, they only had slaves because the slaves were having children. Mm. They were not allowed to import anymore. We're not justifying any part of this. However, the number of slaves brought into Central and South America was hugely larger than the slaves brought to the United States.
好，所以呢，这里有两点哈。第一点呢，那个即兴表演不是说你随便即兴啊，爱怎么奏就怎么奏。好，大家如果去看过这个高手那种爵士的表演、爵士乐表演的话，其实他们都有相当规定、相当严格的一些原则哈。那包括你的这个曲调啊，包括你的节奏啊等等的，它都有限制的。
And how you interact with the other players, that's really important.
而且你跟别人的这个乐手怎么互动都非常重要的哈。那第二点要。这个提醒呢，就是其实啊，当 again 哈、啊，我们不是说这个美国人比较好或者谁比较好，但是历史上的事实就是，这个输送到或者被卖到美国的奴隶呢的数量呢，远远不及被卖到南美洲的黑人奴隶的数量啊。那所以这个也许就是因为这样，所以你在南美洲会可以看到更多的黑人在那边啊。
Yeah.
那另外一点就是，美国其实很早就禁止奴隶输入美国了啊。那这个可是废除奴役制度啊，跟他们禁止奴隶输入之间还隔了一段很长的时间啊。
Yeah.
那主要是因为他们禁止奴隶输入之后呢，原来输入的奴隶他们会有子孙啊，会有小孩、
yeah.
啊，所以这个产生的所谓当时的所谓的奴隶问题。
And somebody made a kind of half humorous comment saying that they had no trouble getting enough slaves because the slaves were reproducing very fast.
那有的人甚至于开这种很冷很黑的玩笑、mm. 说啊，我们没问题啊，你不让我们卖奴隶我也不用买卖啊，反正
不用进啊，
也不用进了，
进口
对、不用进口了哈、因为我已经我足够的这个奴隶，他们可以这个他们的后代就够了。因为在美国的法律啊，父母亲如果是奴隶的话还没有，不管是不是父母亲，就算其中一个
有一滴血，
对，你只要是有一滴血啊，血缘是黑人的话，
你就是黑人
。而且如果你的妈妈或者你的爸爸是奴隶，你自动就成为奴隶，而且你自动就属于那个原来主人的财产
for life。
呀，而且是一辈子。
Okay, so we'll leave that aside for now and go back to what we're talking about here. So a lot of African culture was brought to both of the Americas, and it's the source of many good things in the cultures of both North and South America, one of them being music and dance.
好，所以很这个黑人他们的这个文化呢，在南美洲产生的影响很多。其中一个很重要的部分，其实也就是这里讲他们的这个音乐啊，还有他们的舞蹈。
It is best seen in samba, an internationally popular form of music and dance.
那这个 it is best seen 就是最显而易见的、最容易看到的，就是森巴。啊、那森巴我想大家都听过、啊、那它是什么呢同位格告诉你它是一种 internationally popular 它是一个在国际之间都受到欢迎的一种 form of music and dance、啊、一种音乐跟舞蹈
This unique musical tradition began with the African slaves who were brought to Brazil、
啊、那这里讲得很清楚他说这种 unique 这种独一无二的音乐传统、啊、这个开始怎么开始呢是由这个一些非洲的奴隶、啊、他们被带到这个巴西、啊、从这些被带到巴西的非洲奴隶开始的。
With them came the traditional dances and hypnotic drum rhythms from their homelands. Now that's a pretty powerful description, hypnotic drum rhythms.
Now, hypnotic 就是会催眠的、啊、那其实它这里指的是很吸引人的但是也有那种催眠的感觉因为那种节奏你听着就整个就进入那个节奏里面去了、啊、那这种 hypnotic 的 drum rhythms 就是打鼓的这种节奏、啊、所以 with them 就随着这些这个被进口、啊、这个名字这个动词用的很糟糕但是真的是当时是这样被卖到巴西的这些奴隶随着他们 came、啊、那这个是个倒装句就是Came, 他的这句话真的主词是 came 后面那些东西然后呢 came with them,、啊、那这是原来的句子但他把那 with them 提到前面的强调一下是随着这些人来的、啊、来了什么东西呢来了这个 traditional dances,、啊、就非洲人这些非洲人原来他们的传统的舞蹈还有他们的那种这个催眠引人入胜的这种打鼓的节奏、啊、从他们的 homelands, 从他的家乡带来这些东西。
You might say 陶醉令人陶醉、
啊、陶醉这个 translation、yeah.
进入忘我的境界、mm-hmm. All of those things happen when you really get into it. As the art form expanded, guitars, brass and wind instruments and playful lyrics were added.
好那随着这个 art form 就是 samba、啊、expanded、啊、开始怎么样开始扩展、啊、就开始这个传播、啊、开始这个也开始纳入其他的元素了所以他森巴这种这个开始扩展之后呢就加入了吉他、啊、加入了这个 brass 就是铜管乐器、啊、然后呢 wind instruments 就是管乐器都加进去了还加入了 playful lyrics、啊、playful 是很这个 lighthearted、啊、
顽皮的、
啊、俏皮的他、啊、目的是要 amusement 让你听得觉得很好玩的这样的一种这个歌词呢 were added 都加入了
Samba music and dance steps are always upbeat and they encourage improvisation and self-expression more than most classical dance styles. Now that is something I like about these art forms. One thing I don't really like about European style classical music is it is fixed in form. Once the piece is written, that's the way it stays. You're not allowed to do much with it. You have different interpretations. For example, Glenn Gould, if you've ever heard him perform, he interprets Bach very differently from most other pianists. But in general, you just have to follow the notes. However, in this kind of a musical and dance tradition, you have a lot of room for creativity.
嗯，好，那所以呢，这个地方我们讲到说这个森巴这种音乐还有他们的舞步、啊、dance steps 他的舞步呢都通常、啊、是永远都是 upbeat、啊、就很乐观、啊、很欢乐的很 cheerful 很 optimistic、啊、然后他们 encourage 他们很鼓励呢 improvisation、啊、这个即兴表演、啊、就像刚刚 Karen 老师讲的这个像这种即兴的这种音乐呢你会觉得它很有生命力、啊、那这个相对于这个大部分的欧洲古典音乐呢它写下来就是这样子的你不同的演奏者可以有不同的诠释但基本上它的乐曲是固定的甚至于的乐谱里面都会跟你讲这里要加强这里要减弱、
right.
等等的、
right.
啊、那比较没有办法像这个、啊、这种即兴的音乐随时可以、啊、这个进入可以作为你自我的一种表现、啊、可以炫耀你的技巧等等的、啊、那所以它是一种 他鼓励即兴表演，鼓励 self expression 啊，鼓励艺术家把自己的特色表达出来啊。那 more than 相较于那些更古典的 classical 比较古典的这种 dance styles 这种古典的舞蹈风格啊，你的以前这个古典那种宫廷舞就是那样跳啊，你不能说是跳跳之后跑出来自己把它发挥一下啊，所以这是两者不同。
You know.Even at the time that European classical music was composed and first performed, people fell asleep in concerts.
所以呢，这个欧洲的这种古典音乐一开始的时候呢，很多人听了会在一边听会一边睡着了。
Yeah. Yeah, that's why they wrote the surprise symphony, boom, to suddenly wake people up.
所以才会有那种这个一些会让你很突然就砰很大声的音乐突然间大声啊怎么样就把你叫起来，该起来了，该起来了。
That one's called the Surprise Symphony. You can look it up on YouTube, the Surprise Symphony. The best place to experience the magic of samba music and dancing is at the famous carnival in Rio de Janeiro.
你要体会啊，你要体经验体会一下啊，这个森巴音乐跟舞蹈的这个魔力 magic。那最好的地方就是啊，在这个里约热内卢的嘉年华会。
Celebrated before Lent, it's the world's largest carnival, attracting around 2 million people annually.
它是在这个 Lent, 就是大斋期。在大斋期之前 ,Celebrated, 就是它的这个举行的时间是在大斋期之前，因为接下来就要这个大斋戒了。那它这个里约热内卢的嘉年华会是世界最大的嘉年华会。它每年 annually, 每年吸引大概200万人。
2 million people in the streets with many of them half naked? Not my kind of thing.
Yeah, 这200万人哈，在街上哈，很多人这个衣服都穿得很少，这个感觉起来哈。
It's personal taste, I guess.
Yeah.
The first carnival was organized in 1723.
第一次的嘉年华会是1723年哈，这个是 organized 就是举办的意思。
At the time, there was a lot of tension between the Europeans and Africans living in Brazil. Well, that's understandable. You grabbed me from my homeland and made me a slave. Now, I can't imagine that under those circumstances, people would get along very easily.
所以在1723年的时候呢 there was a lot of tension, 有很多的这个压力很张力双方之间关系很紧张的意思哪双方呢一边是欧洲人一边是这个非洲人就是住在巴西的欧洲人跟非洲人你可能觉得那的原住民跑哪里去呢南美洲在这个殖民的过程当中原住民是几乎被灭种的
Yeah, they were either chased to the mountains like in Taiwan or a lot of them were simply wiped out often by disease
Yeah, 所以他们要么就被赶到山里面去了要么就几乎整族的灭亡了很多时候是因为疾病天花什么的那有的时候是用武力 Yeah
One thing I have to throw in is that the slaves, in fact, were actually grabbed and sold by native Africans. Africans had already been selling slaves within Africa. The Europeans just gave them a foreign market.
所以这个黑奴呢，黑人奴隶呢，其实在非洲本身，他们的这个不同的黑人的就会去抓别的黑人来这个卖当做奴隶贩卖他们本身非洲就有这种奴隶的这个贩卖制度了是后来欧洲人是把这奴隶贩卖制度打开了他的海外市场
还可以外销
还可以外销
That's right So they had a slave system a slave sales network going on long before the white people came Instead of fighting, celebrating together was a way for them to put their differences aside for a short while so they could partyplay music and dance in the streets.
这个蛮聪明的。Instead of fighting, 我们不要打架。我们呢 celebrating together, 我们一起庆祝。那这样子就是一个方法可以 for them to, a way for somebody to do something. 那这里就是让他们能够怎么样能够 put their differences aside, 把他们的这个中间的差异他们不同的意见可以 put aside, 暂时放到一边 for a short while, 强调这只是暂时的那这样子的话呢他们就可以 party, 可以这个欢乐通常是在这个一群人里面欢乐那叫 party, 或者一群人一起欢乐他们可以 play music, 他们可以这个听音乐玩音乐演奏音乐还可以 dance in the streets, 所以有一点把让他们借用这个机会让他们能够同欢至少把他们的这个energy 释放一下。
different social classes mixed together, allowing people to drop their identities and pretend to be someone else temporarily.
好，那不同的社会阶层啊 ，social classes 啊，就是社会的阶级，不同社会阶级呢 ，mixed together 啊，他们就混在一起啊。那 allowing 这可以使得 people 让人们可以干嘛呢 ？Allow somebody to do something 啊，所以可以让 people 来 drop their identities， 可以放下他们的身份啊。或者他们的认同 ，identities 可能是身份，可能是认同。啊，他我是大地主啊，但是呢，哎，我暂时可以放下我的身份，跟大家一起玩。那我只是个奴隶，但是我也可以不，也许奴隶还不行啊，就是我可能啊，我是这个不是很有钱的人，但是我可以把我的身份放下来，暂时跟大家一起玩。所以他们可以 pretend to be， 好，可以假装是，好 ，pretend to 后面加个动词啊，在后面这里动词是 be， 所以他们可以假装是 someone else， 另外一个人啊 ，temporarily 暂时啊，这个 again 它提供一个机会让你暂时脱离你的 existence， 这个对你的身心健康都有好处。
I think the slaves also did participate.
哦，所以奴隶应该也是有参加的。
Rich citizens often dressed like beggars and roamed the streets, while the poor put on expensive threads. Now, threads is a very slangy word for clothes. Threads 是线，就是那个用来织布的线。But it was popular in the 1950s. Threads was popular slang in the 1950s. You still hear it now, but not very often.
啊，所以 threads 本来是线的意思，那这个是。在这里指的是衣服啊，这是1950年代的这个俚语啊，现在比较少听到，但是偶尔还会看到啊。那所以这里讲到说，这个有钱的市民 ,rich citizens 啊，他们常常会穿得像乞丐一样啊 ,dressed like beggars, 然后 roamed the streets, roam 就是那个游荡啊，他们装成乞丐在街上游荡，体会一下无家可归的人那种感觉。那没有钱的人呢，他们会 put on, 会穿戴啊 ,expensive, 很贵的threads 衣服，所以角色互换一下，彼此体会一下对方的生活。
This reminds me of a book by Mark Twain, The Prince and the Pauper.
Oh, yeah, 这个马克吐温的一个在台湾比较少人看的一个文那个一个故事啊，其实。
Oh,
yeah,
okay. So The Prince and the Pauper is a poor man and a prince who exchange clothes and exchange roles.
啊，所以他的故事里面就是一个有钱人跟一个很穷的人呢，他们彼此是互换衣服也互换身份的一个故事。
Pretty fun. All right. People also cross-dressed, wore masks, and even went around with almost nothing on at all, which is a tradition that continues to this day. Cross-dressing means that 男扮女装 and also the reverse. So if guys dress up like women and women dress up like men. They wore masks, and wearing almost nothing at all is what you really see. If you look at any videos of carnival, that's what you'll see. A lot of almost naked people.
Mm.所以呢，人们会 cross-dressed， 就是跨性别穿着，男生穿男扮女装，女扮男装啊。然后 wore masks 啊，他们会戴面具。那甚至于呢 ，went around 就到处爬照啊 ，with almost nothing on at all， 身上几乎没有穿什么衣服啊。那这个呢，其实已经是一个 tradition， 一个传统，而且呢，持续到今天 ，a tradition that continues to this day。
You really have to have a good figure to pull that one off.
Yeah.你要这样子的话，那身材要够好，不然的话，这个会伤人家眼睛。
Yeah. During carnival, street parades are held throughout the cities of Brazil.
好，所以在嘉年华期间呢，街上的这个游行呢，啊，这整个在巴西的各个都市里面都有街道的游行。
Groups of people from the same neighborhoods and samba school students and teachers proudly show off their talents.
好，所以from the same neighborhoods, 同一个社区的人群呢就一群群人来自同一个社区的或者是这个森巴学校的学生跟老师呢他们会很骄傲的 show off, 会展示他们的 talents, 他们的才华。
That sounds fun. The dancers dress in elaborate costumes and shake their bodies to the powerful percussive sounds coming from the live marching bands.
好那这些舞蹈者他们穿着 elaborate 就是很精美的好这个 costumes 服饰服装哈 costumes 通常是指某一个国家或某一个时期某一个地区的特别的服装或者是戏服啊所以他们穿着精美的这个服饰然后呢 shake their bodies 啊他们的这个身体摇摆他们的身体 to 就是搭配什么什么的节奏以什么什么伴奏啊他们根据什么来 这个摇晃身体呢，根据这个强而有力的 percussive 就是打击乐的这种声音啊，是谁来哪里来的这种打击乐的声音呢？是来自于 the live marching bands， 就是现场的这个啊乐队啊，这个所以乐队也跟着游行，那他们跟着这个音乐队奏出来乐曲呢，这个起舞。
Anything goes at carnival, so everyone is free to join the fun and display their best dance moves.
好 ,anything goes, 就像我们刚刚讲的百无禁忌，所以在嘉年华会上百无禁忌，所以每个人都可以很自由的啊 ,join the fun, 啊就加入这个欢乐的行列，然后 display, 展示他们最棒的 their best dance moves, 最棒的舞步可以展示。
Maybe you better start practicing at home. We'll see you next time. Bye bye.
Bye bye.